Hey guys, Tyler Berger here with Bass Fishing HQ, and today I want to talk about swim baits. From your little swim baits to your big swim baits and everything in between. And not only that, I want to talk about five big mistakes that a lot of guys make when they're swim bait fishing, so stay tuned, it's gonna be a good one. Before we get into the video, I have some extremely exciting news. Back when I was in high school and college, I can remember thinking of how awesome it would be to start a fishing apparel business. I really wanted to start a company who made clothes devoted towards the angler. Now, there are several companies that are doing this out on the market, but I'm excited to announce to you guys today that I have started my own fishing apparel company called Finn Fishing. This is actually named after my son. His name is Thomas Finn. I've been working a lot over the last year to try and find a specific material, a specific way of producing fishing apparel that anglers are going to love. So right in time for Thanksgiving, I actually got the first batch of inventory in. It's very limited stock, and this is top of the line. As you can see, I have mesh going from the arms throughout the entire back that really allows you to keep cool. It's obviously going to protect you from the sun, but one of the biggest things that I love about these shirts is how comfortable they are when you wear them. That was one of my main goals, because we wear these style of shirts for 8, 10, 12 hours sometimes. And something specific I love about this material is it doesn't show every blemish that's on your body like some shirts out there do. I have this bluish hooded performance sun shirt. I also have one without a hood that is more of a gray camo finish. Right now, I wanted to give you guys the opportunity to actually buy this clothing at a discounted rate before I start marketing it. So if you use the coupon code YouTube20, you can actually get 20% off these shirts. You have a pretty limited stock. So if you guys wanna purchase some of the sun shirts, I would suggest you go ahead and grab some right now. Let's get on to swim bait fishing. The first mistake that a lot of anglers make while fishing swim baits is using too big of a hook with their swim bait. Now, when I'm talking about a swim bait in this case, what I'm really referring to is your soft swim baits that you actually put a jig head into. You know, one of the most popular types of swim bait that is like this is a Kytec. You know, there's a lot of other companies that have come out with a very similar type of swim bait, like the Rage Swimmer from Strike King or the Saucy Swimmer from Guggen. They are all a very similar bait that you actually put a jig head in. Now, the big mistake that I see that a lot of guys make is they put a jig head in there that has a hook on it that is simply too big for the soft plastic that they are fishing. If you put a really big hook in a Kytec style swim bait, it really impedes the action of that bait. It's not gonna have near the movement in the water, and it's not really gonna have that natural look that really makes the swim bait such a good lure. So when I'm fishing that Kytec style bait, I really like to try to have a little bit lighter of a hook because it really allows that bait to have a lot of movement. Not only is the tail going to wiggle more, but the head of it is also going to wiggle more, and it just looks a lot more natural coming through the water. Now, obviously, there are some situations where you have to use a thicker and a bigger hook in this style of swim bait. But when you can fish a little bit lighter wire and a little bit shorter of a hook, I'm telling you, it's gonna help you to get twice as many bites as the other person who might be fishing a bigger hook. The second mistake that a lot of guys make when it comes to fishing a swim bait is actually fishing it on too heavy a tackle. Kind of going along with what we just talked about with hook, sometimes using a little bit lighter tackle as far as line diameter and even rods allows you to have a little bit more action in that bait. Now, if you're throwing really big, gigantic swim baits, you know, like giant glide baits or really big boot tail style swim baits, you obviously have to use heavy tackle to throw those heavier lures. But if you're fishing, again, that Kytec style bait, sometimes actually using 8-pound tests as opposed to 12 or 15-pound tests can make a huge difference on the number of bites that you're getting. And it's not just with Kytecs, it's also with other baits. For instance, a 6-inch Magdraft swim bait is one of my favorite swim baits to fish. Now, if you looked at this bait, you might think I need to fish that on 20-pound tests, 25-pound tests, but If you listen to Chris Zaudane talk about that specific swim bait, he repeatedly talks about fishing it on 15-pound fluorocarbon line, which in my mind, when I first heard that, it just seemed like smaller than I would want to, right? Because this is a swim bait. This is a bait that can catch a 6, 7, 8, 10-pound bass. Do I really want to be fishing it on 15-pound line? But if you fish that bait on 15-pound line as opposed to 20-pound line, that head of the bait actually wobbles a lot more, as well as the tail. It just has a lot better action, which is going to help you to get more bites on that bait. So using a little bit lighter equipment and not always the heavy equipment is going to help you to get a lot more bites on a swim bait. The third mistake that a lot of guys make when it comes to fishing a swim bait, and this is a little bit more specific to those bigger swim baits, is that thinking that the swim baits are only meant for catching bass. And I know that that kind of sounds weird when I talk about it, right? Like, what else would you use a swim bait for? But here's the thing, a swim bait is a great, it's a phenomenal tool that we have as anglers to actually just locate bass. So this is something that I learned on Lake Norman down in North Carolina. That particular lake has a ton of fish on it, and it has a ton of boat docks on it. And it doesn't really always make sense to just try to weed through all these fish to try to find and catch those little bit bigger bass. So something that you can do is actually utilize a big swim bait. You can cast this down right next to a dock and actually just reel that out right beside the dock. Now, bass are either gonna hit that swim bait as it comes by, or what you see a lot of times is that the bass are simply going to just follow that swim bait out from under the dock. And so what you're gonna be able to do is actually locate the docks that have better sized bass on them. You're gonna be like, that dock has a 3-pounder on it. That dock has a 4-pounder on it. That dock has a 5-pounder on it. And then you can go back during a tournament or the next day, you can skip a jig under there, you can skip a wacky rig under there, and you can catch that fish that you found with the swim bait. So again, swim baits are not just made for catching fish, they are a great tool for finding fish. The fourth mistake that a lot of anglers make with a swim bait is not using the right jig head when you're using a swim bait that requires one. Again, like a Kytec. When I'm fishing very open water situations, I tend to use a ball head jig in my swim bait. To me, I feel like that ball head really gives that bait a lot of action when you're fishing it in open water. Now, if I'm fishing that bait down on the bottom, a lot of times I'm fishing it in a rocky area or maybe an area that has a lot of shell. And in that case, I'm actually gonna put a football head jig on my swim bait. And if I'm fishing that bait around a lot of grass, maybe I'm fishing it down in Florida around a lot of hydrilla, then I'm actually gonna use a little bit more of your traditional swim bait jig head, one that has a little bit more of a pointed nose, because that's gonna really allow that bait to come through that grass without getting constantly hung up on the head of the jig itself. So make sure that you're using the right jig head for the situation that you are fishing. The fifth mistake that a lot of anglers make with a swim bait is thinking that the swim bait is only a big fish bait. Now, obviously, a lot of us throw swim baits to catch big fish. But no matter where you live in the country, even the guys that live out in California, I know a couple of guys that live out there. I've read articles, I've watched TV shows, and they'll all tell you the same thing. Even when you're throwing a 12-inch swim bait, you're gonna catch a lot of 2 and 3 pounders from time to time on that bait. And I have seen the same thing over here on the east side of the United States when I'm fishing a 6-inch swim bait, which in my mind is a pretty big swim bait, but I'm catching a lot of 1-pounders on the bait. So a bigger swim bait doesn't just catch big fish. You can actually have some really great days throwing a swim bait around and catching a lot of fish, as well as catching some big fish on it. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys want to check out some of the fin fishing apparel, you can click this link right here. If you want to pick some up, go ahead and do so. If you don't want to pick some up, I still love you and I thank you for watching. Please comment below, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.